Hi friends, now I'll ask you one question. If you want to find out square root or let's say cube root or the fourth root of a complex number, then how you will find? Now, as we find roots or the powers in real number, you can still find roots or powers or certain expansions of complex number also. But how to find it? So, in this topic, I'm gonna teach you how to find certain expansions, roots, and powers of complex number. Now this has become possible only because of one scientist whose name is Abraham D. Moivre. So he has derived a formula using which we can very easily find out roots or the powers or expansion of complex numbers as we do with real numbers. So that is why this theorem is called as D. Moivre's theorem. So name of the topic that we are starting today is nothing but D. Moivre's theorem. Now, what Abraham D. Moivre says. So, according to him, if you want to find out power or root of complex number, let's say it is n. So, n is any rational number. It means it can be a whole number or it can be a fraction. So, cos theta plus I sin theta is a complex number. And we are trying to find out power of this complex number. So, D. Moivre says, whenever you are finding a power of a complex number, that time it will become cos n theta plus I sin n theta. It means your power will multiply the amplitude of complex number. Now, let's take some example. Example, if you have a complex number, let's say cos theta plus I sin theta, raised to 5. It means you want to find fifth power of this complex number. So, according to D. Moivre, it will become cos of 5 theta plus I sin 5 theta. Suppose, let's say it is minus. It means if we have cos theta plus I sin theta raised to minus 5. Then what will happen? Same result. This minus 5 will multiply the amplitude of the complex number. So, it will become cos of minus 5 theta plus I sin minus 5 theta. Now, we all know that cos of minus theta is cos theta. Hence, cos of minus 5 theta is, yes, it is cos 5 theta. Similarly, sin of minus 5 theta is minus sin 5 theta. So, it will become minus I sin 5 theta. So, it means if you want to find out negative power of any positive complex number, then the sign will become negative. And vice versa is also true. It means cos 5 theta minus I sin 5 theta is given to you. Then you can write it down as cos theta plus I sin theta whole raised to minus 5. Now let's take some fraction. So, if it is cos theta plus I sin theta raised to 2 by 3. In this case, what will happen? Same rule, 2 by 3, it will multiply this theta. So, it will become cos of 2 by 3 theta plus I sin 2 by 3 theta. So, according to D. Moivre, whatever is the power or the root that you are finding for any complex number, that power or root will multiply amplitude of the complex number. So, using this theorem, we will see some numericals and let's solve some numericals using the result of D. Moivre.